Today we are going to see introduction to computers part 2. Already we have seen part 1. So before moving the lesson, we should recap our last class. Introduction to computers part 1 recap. So last class we have discussed about this functional units of computers. Input units gets the instructions from the user, and the control unit passes the instructions to CPU, and CPU do all the calculations and send the output to the output unit. This is the simple working principles of computer. So in this chapter, in this sessions, we will going to see some input devices and output devices. Okay, input and output devices, and this is the first most common used input device. So that is keyboard. Okay, we'll see the parts of keyboard and types of keys is in keyboard. Okay, and first one, the first row is called function keys. F1, F2, up to F9 is that. These are function keys. And next one is, this is navigation keys. That is, its navigation means directions. It's used to change the directions of the cursor or focus of the computer. Okay, that is navigation key. And next one is numeric keypad. Here, the numbers are here, and plus, minus, divide, multiple, everything is here. This is numeric keypad. Then system and GUI keys. This is Win key is here, and next one is GUI key. That is right left button, mouse right left button key is here. That is GUI key, and system and GUI key. And next one is modifier keys. Modifier keys means shift, control, and alt is the modifier keys. And next one is, this is the character keys. The individual characters and numbers, special characters are character keys. The remaining key, all the keys are called character keys. Here, special characters means at symbol, then and symbol. These are all special characters. Hash is there, dollar is there. So these are all character keys. And lock keys. Lock keys means caps lock, and caps lock, screen lock, and number lock is the lock keys. And next one is enter and editing keys. And del keys, backspace keys, and enter keys are enter and edit keys. Enter keys means give OK or come to the next line. This is enter key. And edit keys, editing keys, you know that backspace keys, del keys is the editing keys. If you want to edit something, means we should use this keys, that is backspace keys or del key we are using here. Okay, this is a parts of the keyboard and types of keys in keyboard. Okay, so I'll discuss about keyboard. Keyboard, we have wired keyboard is here, wireless keyboard is here, virtual keyboard is here. This is a keyboard, and this is the most common input device used today. Okay, this is the most common input device. If you want to give anything to the computer, means we'll give through this keyboard only. That is individual keys for letters, numbers, and special characters are collectively known as character keys. Already we saw this. And next one is, the keyboard key is derived from the keyboard of original typewriters. So this is look like a typewriter only. Okay, this is derived from typewriter only. So next one is, the data and instructions are given as input to the computer by typing on the keyboard. If you want to give any data or instructions, given to the computer means, so this is how we can give through the computers. We should type that. Okay, we should type the instruction or data through the keyboard. And apart from alphabet and numeric keys, except alphabet and numeric key, it also has function keys for performing different functions. So apart from alphabetic and numeric keys, that is character keys, we have function keys also there. Already we saw that function key, that is top row is called function key, F1, F2, F3, up to F9. So F1 is used for help, F2 is used for rename, F3 for open the particular applications, etc. So we have different functions keys performing different functions. Okay, so next one is there are different set of keys available in the keyboard, such as character keys, modifier keys, system and GUI keys, enter and editing keys, function keys, navigation keys, numeric keypad and lock keys. So these keys are already we saw in this previous screen. So this is the keyboard. So next, let's see history of mouse. Dr. Engelbert invented and developed mouse during the year 1960s. It was patented on November 17, 1970s. After 10 years only, he got patent rights. And now, let's see about mouse. Mouse, we have wired mouse or wireless mouse. Mouse is a pointing device used to control the movement of the cursor on the display screen. We know that. So we have cursor for this is a pointing device. And next one, it can be used to select icon, menu, command button, or active something on a computer. Okay, how you give the input to the mouse? So click the icon, or click the menu, or click any command button. So this is active something on a computer. And some mouse actions are move, click, double click, right click, drag and drop. So what are the mouse actions? We can move the mouse pointer. So this is a mouse pointer. We can move the mouse pointer. Single click means do some actions. Double click means open that particular application. Right click means we can see that property of the application. Drag and drop means we can drag the icon to drop anywhere, or we can select something in the monitor and drag it and drop the something. That is, we can move through this using this drag and drop. Okay, and next one is different types of mouse available are mechanical mouse, optical mouse, and laser mouse, air mouse, 3D mouse, tactile mouse, ergonomic mouse, and gaming mouse. Okay, let's see about types of mouse. Mechanical mouse. This is inside of the mechanical mouse. This is the inside of the mechanical mouse. A ball is kept inside and touch the pad through a hole at the bottom of the mouse. Okay, bottom of the mouse, we have one ball. The ball only touch the mouse pad. So that only send the signal to the computer. When the mouse is moved, the ball rolls. This movement of the ball is converted into signals and sent to the computer. So in this mechanical mouse, we have two buttons, that is right mouse button and left mouse button. Okay, and this is invented by Telefunken. This is German company in the year of 1968. So next we have to see optical mouse. So this is optical mouse. Here, instead of ball, the lights used to send the signal. Measure the motions and acceleration of pointer. It uses a light source instead of ball to judge the motions of the pointers. Instead of ball, here the light only judge the motion of the pointer. The motion means movement of the pointers. That is mouse pointer. Pointer means here mouse pointer. An optical mouse has three buttons. So one is right mouse button and another one is left mouse button. Next one is the middle, we have one scroll button. Okay, optical mouse is less sensitive towards surface. It is less sensitive, so the surface should be smooth. Otherwise, the mouse cannot send the signal to computer. And the optical mouse invented by Richard Yan, Steve Krish in the year of 1988. Both are invented different versions of optical mouse. The next one, laser mouse. This is laser mouse. Nowadays we are using this mouse only. Instead of light, here laser lights are used. Measures the motions and accelerations of pointer. Laser mouse uses laser lights. Laser mouse is highly sensitive and able to work on any hard surface. So this laser light is highly sensitive, so we can work without a mouse pad. So this is scanner. We are all knowing this. Using the scanner, we can give the input, that is photos or any documents. So we can scan it and store it in the computer's memory. Scanners are used to enter the information directly into the computer's memory. Okay, so this is one of the input device. And next one is, this device works like a Xerox machine. We know that about Xerox machine. So the same one, this also work like a Xerox machine, but the copies are sent to the computer's memory. The scanner converts any type of printed or written information, including photographs, into a digital format, which can be manipulated by the computer. Okay, so we can printed format or photographs are directly convert to the digital format through this scanner. Fingerprint scanner, this is one of the input device. This is a fingerprint scanner. This is nothing but our biometric. Fingerprint scanner is a fingerprint recognition device used for computer security, equipped with the fingerprint recognition features that uses biometric technology. So this is nothing but biometric technology. It recognizes our fingerprints. It identifies us. Used to identify us. Fingerprint reader or scanner is a very safe and convenient device for security instead of using password, which is vulnerable to fraud and is hard to remember. Okay, so instead of using password, the fingerprint is very easy and very safe, because we may forget our password. Otherwise, other person may use our password. Let me see the next input device. Trackball. This is trackball. This is one of the input device. In the mechanical mouse, the ball is bottom of the mouse. But in trackball, the ball is top of the mouse. The trackball is similar to the upside down design of the mouse. The user moves the ball directly while the device itself remains stationary. The user not necessarily move the mouse, so it's they are move the balls directly. The user pins the ball in various directions to navigate the screen movement. The next input device is retinal recognition. Retinal scanner. How you use the fingerprint, that is the biometric or fingerprint scanner? So the same method, we are, instead of fingers, we are using eyes here. So let's see. This performs a retinal scanner, which is a biometric technique that uses technique patterns on a person's retinal blood vessels. It's recognize our the persons using retinal eyes blood vessels. Okay, so this is retina scanner. This is one of the input device, and next one is a light pen. This is light pen. This is look like our normal pen, but we can write using this in directly to the monitor. A light pen is a pointing device, sharp like a pen, and is connected to a monitor. The pen is connected to the monitor, then only we can write in the monitor. The tip of the light pen contains the light sensitive element, which detects the light from the screen, enabling the computer to identify the location of the pen on the screen. Okay. The tip must be touch the screen. When the tip touch the screen, it detects some lights. The light signal should send to the computer. It's identify the location of the pen. The light pens have the advantages of drawing directly on the screen, but this becomes hard to use and is also not accurate. So if you want to draw or if you want to write anything means in directly to the computer means we can write this light pen, but we can't say this is accurate. So the next input device is optical character reader. This is the optical character reader. It is a device which detects characters printed or written on a paper with OCR. A user can scan a page from the book. So this optical character reader used to scan the pages from the book. It may be printed or written. The computer will recognize the characters in the page as letters and punctuation marks and stores. And the scanned document can be edited using the word processor. So if it is writing document or printed document, we can scan this and store in the computer and use in the word processing for editing or updating something. Okay, so the next input device is barcode or QR code reader. This is, we have all seen this object that is in the supermarket or any big store. We can see this for bill section. A barcode is a pattern printing in line of different thickness. We can see this barcode in soap, pen or everything. So the barcode reader used to read the barcode. From this barcode, line thickness and thinner differentiate this line. It's identify the product name. The barcode reader scans the information on the barcode, transmit to the computer for further processing. So it's directly transmit to the computer. This is which product is this, and the system gives fast and error-free entry of information to the computer. Okay, so the system easily accept this object, which object we are going to buy, which item we are going to buy. The system recognizes fastly. And next one is QR code, that is quick response code. This is also the same one. The QR code is the two-dimension barcode which can be direct read by a camera and processed to interpret the image. So the next input device is voice input systems. So do you know this? What is this? This is a mic. Microphone serves as a voice input devices. We all know this, how this works. So microphone serves as a voice input device, and it captures the voice data and sends it to the computer. Using the microphone alone with speech recognition software can offer a completely new approach to input information into the computers. So next input device is digital camera. So this is also, we know that we are all knowing this digital cameras. It captures images or video directly in the digital form. It uses CCD, that is chargeable. Charge coupled device, electronic chip. When light falls on the chip, through this lens, it converts light rays into digital camera. This is also one of the input device. Next one is touch screen. So we use this touch, we are all using this touch screen, that is mobile and ATM, everything. So a touch screen is a display device that allows the user to interact with the computer by using the fingers. So through the fingers, we are using this touch screen, and it can be quite useful as an alternative to the mouse or keyboard for navigating the graphical user interface. So instead of mouse or keyboard, we are using our fingers to navigate the screen, that is direct the screen. Touchscreens are used on a wide variety of devices such as computers, laptop, monitors, smartphones, cash registers, and information kiosks. Some touchscreens use a grid of infrared beams to sense the presence of finger instead of utilizing touch sensitive input. So we can use instead of finger any touch sensitive objects. Okay. So the next input device is keyer. This is keyer. Keyer is like a keyboard. It's working like a keyboard, not an actual keyboard. This is working like a keyboard. We can keep inside our hands. That is, this is a palm keyboard. A keyer is a device for signaling by hand by way of pressing one or more switches. Modern keyers have a large number of switches, but not as many as a full-size keyboard. So it has a lot of switches we can control with our fingers, but this is not a full-size keyboard. Typically, this number is between 4 and 15. A keyer difference from a keyboard, which has no board, but the keys are arranged in a cluster. So this is not this keyer has, there is no any arrangement, but this is arranged in a cluster. The user must practice with this keyer. That's why that only we can use this keyer easily. That's all input devices and output devices and generation of computers. We will see in the next class.